Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the earlier session, we had seen indexing a NumPy array with some examples with positive indexes and negative indexes. And today, let's move on to slicing a NumPy array. So friends, we have seen slicing in list tuples. So the same slicing is applicable in NumPy array. So what does slicing means? Slicing means to fetch a range of elements from a NumPy array from the start index to the stop index for the specified step size. So this is the definition of slicing in NumPy array. Slicing in NumPy array means to fetch a range of elements, more than one element, from a NumPy array, from the start index to the stop index for the specified step size. So we're having three parameters. One is the start index, the other is the stop index, and the step size. So with these three values, we can do slicing in NumPy array. The syntax for using slicing in NumPy array is array name. We have to give the array name, then square brackets. We have to give the start index, colon, stop index, colon, step size. So these are the three values, and all the three values are optional. So if we don't specify the start index, that it considers the default values. So the default values for start index is from beginning of NumPy array. And the default value for the stop index is end of NumPy array. And the default value for step size is equal to 1. So friends, all the three fields are optional. And in any case, if we don't specify the start index, it will consider from beginning of NumPy array. If we don't specify the stop index, it will consider till the end of NumPy array. And if we don't specify the step count, by default, it will take 1 as the step count. So, definition is, fetches a range of elements from a NumPy array from the start index to the stop index for the specified step size. And the start, stop and step are differentiated. In between start, stop and step, we are having a colon symbol. So we saw the definition and syntax of using slicing in NumPy array. And now let's see one example with a one-dimensional array. So one-dimensional array, slicing in 1D array. Firstly, let me say import NumPy as np, and then let me say my array 1 is equal to np.array and let me say 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and then 80. So this is my one-dimensional array, and this array is stored in array 1. And now let me do the slicing operation on array 1. So I have to give array name, that is array 1. The name of the array to which we have to perform slicing is array 1. So I give an array name, square brackets. I specify my start index as 1, stop index as 6. Okay, I specify start and stop index. Now, let me have my array over here. It's 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, and then 80. For slicing, we are considering the index values. So, what are the index values? This is a 0th index, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. And what are the negative indexes? It's minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and minus 8. So now I've given my start index as 1, colon, stop index as 6. Start index value starts from 1. And it won't consider the 6th index. It will consider 6 minus 1 index, that is the 5th index. So 1 to 5, all the elements will be fetched. That is 20, 30, 40, 50, and then 60. So this is at the 1st index, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and the 5th index. So it consider from 1 to 5th index. It won't consider the last index. It will exclude the last index value. Now, if I say print array 1, I don't specify my start index. I'll give the end index as 5. So what will happen, friends? When I don't specify the start index, it will take the default value, that is from the beginning of the array. So it will take from 0th index till n minus 1, 5 minus 1, that is 4th index. So it will consider 10 to 50. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 till the 4th index. 20, 30, 40, and then 50. Let me take another example. Print array 1. I specify my start index as 2 and I won't specify any stop index. So when I don't give any stop index, it will span from the second index till the end of the array. So at the second index, I'm having 30. So to consider from 30 till end of the array, that is 80. 40, 50, 60, 70, and then 80. And now, if I say print array 1, if I give a negative index, minus 4, colon, minus 1. Minus 4 is 50. Minus 1 is 80. It won't consider minus 1. It will end at the previous value, that is minus 2. So, minus 4 to minus 2 is 50, 60 and 70. So, the value would be 50, 60 and then 70. And now, let me consider the step size. 1, colon, 6, colon, 2. Friends, still here I have not considered the step size, so it was taking 1 as the step count. But here I have specified the step size as 2. So it will omit one item and consider the next item from 1st index to 5th index. 1st index is 20, till the fifth index is 60. So it will omit every alternate number. So it will consider the first one, that is 20. It will omit 30. It will consider 40. It will omit 50. And it will consider 60. It won't consider 80 because my step size ends at 6. And we have to consider only till 5. So this is the value which we got on the console. Again, if I say array 1 colon colon 3. So in this particular scenario, it will consider from beginning of the array till end of the array, because I have not given start and stop index. So it will consider from beginning of the array till end of the array, and it will skip every two numbers in between. It will write the first number, that is 10. It will skip 20, 30. It will write 40. 50, 60 get skipped, and it will write 70. Hope so, friends. It is clear for you. Here we have the start and stop index. Stop index, we have to exclude the stop index, and we have to consider only till n minus 1. Here we saw that we didn't have the start index, so we considered from the beginning of the array. Here we didn't have the end in stop index, so we considered till the end of the array. For negative indexes, we had this particular example. With step size 2, it omitted every alternate element, and with step size 3, it omitted 2 numbers. After every number, 2 numbers were omitted, and the 4th one was printed. 4, and again 2 elements were omitted, 5th and 6th, and the 7th item was printed. Hope so, friends, it is clear for you how to slice a one-dimensional NumPy array in Python programming language. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button, and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.